Hey guys, welcome back. Yeah, in today's video, we're gonna paint this water rock scene here. Yeah, we grab a set of colors, those seven ones on the left side here, and mix a set of colors for the underpainting, for the first layer we're gonna use. It's very in-detailed way of building up colors here on this underpainting, basically. Very simple, straightforward, more or less. We're having three colors for the sky, as you can see here. The darkest one, bit of a lighter one, and the very lightest one. And I more or less just apply them horizontal, more or less, and blend them. Very easy, very straightforward. I don't mix in too much linseed oil. This might seem a bit funny that I'm using. Yeah, for some of you this might be a bit too fast, therefore make sure you check out my Patreon, where you can see meanwhile over 60 videos in a full-time version, including the color mixing process, between 2 and 7 hours of in-detail painting. Link is somewhere down below here. Helps to get in the details in the first place easier. Like here, for example, the rocks that I'm paint here now. Basically, it looks not very 3D, to be honest. Just getting in those rough colors locations more or less first. Then I let the whole thing dry for a couple of days and start to build up on the complete dry surface. Really make sure it's completely dry when you try to put it on the next layer of color. When it's just a bit sticky, you might lift off the color. Therefore, really make sure you do not get back too early. Yeah, and then you see, I basically just mix two colors for the cloud part. And the trick here is, again, like in so many other videos of mine, the control of the color amount that you use to manipulate the color itself, as you can see here. We just have two colors, but with all those very fine variations that we have here, basically the amount of color is reduced in some places. We basically simulate some more colors. I'm going back, grab some more phthalo blue, and start to build up the dark areas of the cloud here, as you can see. Looks a bit weird off at this moment here, but basically just establishing the lighter outline on the top first, and then I go back and build up those darker areas here. You can see those kind of shadowy areas from the clouds. I use some soft brush here to really blend the whole thing, get in some kind of a softness. And then I start to build up the ripples, the waves on the water part. And this takes quite a while, as you can see here. You need to be really patient and really be very kind of random, as you can see here. Don't repeat yourself too often. Really try to get in those softer, darker blue tones completely random, so that you really get the impression of this water surface here. And then I mix a lighter set of colors for the reflections that we have here. And this way it's very easy to build up water, as you don't have to constantly change your brushes. You just need to add lighter colors on the top of the still or the already dry color that we applied before, and this didn't took too long, and it's a very easy way of getting in details. And basically the same approach is done with the rock part, more or less. You see, we have established the rough color scheme beforehand, Then we let the whole thing dry, of course, and then we start to build up those very fine little details here and there, as you can see here. For this you need to thin down the color quite a bit. And again, be random. Don't repeat yourself too often. Get in some very fine details. You need a very pointed brush for this, a very small pointed brush. Yeah, and then I go back and grab some bit larger brush and start to rework those areas where I think I need to have some more softness in there. And this really helps to communicate this rocky character of this rock here. Basically, it's a rock that we paint here, and rocks have all kinds of structures and different colors and lots of detail. I mean, you can't put in all of those details, of course, but you want to have some color variation. Like here, I'm adding this redness here and there. And then, of course, you also need to add those reflections, those watery areas, more or less. And on the right side, we have some kind of moss or some greens on the rock part here. And this whole combination of those colors that we have here and those details, those finer ones, those reflections from the water and so on, really help to communicate this rocky character, more or less. And the water on the right side is built up the same way, more or less. Adding some lighter colors, some highlights here and there, and of course some darker colors for the bigger waves that we have here and there. And I decided to show you this process here in a time lapse because it's really time consuming and you just need to grasp the basic idea. And the basic idea, as you can see here, is basically you add the darker tones, and those are basically the shadow parts of the waves that we have here coming in. And you need to let this darker color fade out towards the bottom part of the wave. And then you just need to add some more lighter tones here. And of course a very fine, nearly pure titanium white reflections here. here and there on the wave parts. And this really is a very easy way of building up water wave details, as you can see here. With just the dark color, it looks in the beginning very flat, very funny somehow, a bit off. Then you add the lighter color to flesh out the wave a bit more. And then you go back again, the color still wet, and build up those very fine white water foam parts here and there that we have here coming in. And this really helps to build up a very quick, a very efficient way, those very fine little watery details that you want to have here. And basically the same goes for the white water part here on the left area. You can see I'm just hinting the outline of the rock, more or less. And start to build up basically the foam parts, the white water parts, the parts where the water breaks and where the water gets foamy around this rock here. Very fine boned, very detailed, very fine lines here and there. And again, don't repeat yourself. Try to really get in those little fuzzy details, more or less, as you can see here. You also need to put them onto the rocks, as you can see here. And it's a very controlled and very easy way of building up water details. And the same basically goes for the parts in the front, as you can see here. We have basically the water shaping all kinds of forms, and the area where the light hits direct needs to be, yeah, more or less kind of highly reflective with this nearly pure titanium white. And yeah, you see here now nearly done, and yeah, ended up with a very nice and realistic looking water part here. Yeah, and we're finished. Yeah, that's it for today, but before you leave, make sure you check out one of these other two videos here.